Natural disasters pose an overwhelming threat to humanity, and as members of the Crisis Response Unit, you and your team are uniquely capable of providing relief. Players will need to roll their dice as quickly as possible to create supplies and deliver them around the world to cities in need. Pandemic Rapid Response is a race against time where you and your team must quickly work together in order to win the game and save the world. To set up the game, place the game board on the table. Then take the four supply crates and place them in the matching colored room. You will be creating these supplies and delivering them during the game. Place the waste marker on the first space of the waste track. This will mark how much waste is created when you create supplies. Then place the timer and three time tokens in HQ. These tokens will be spent to flip the timer to add more time to the game. The remaining time tokens can be placed off the board near the cargo bay. You'll gain more tokens when you make deliveries. Next, give each player a roll card, a reference card, set of dice, and matching player pawn. Each roll has a special ability that can help during the game. For example, the analyst can re-roll their dice up to two additional times, while the flight planner can move the plane an additional city for every plane die result. Place each player's pawn in the starting room shown on their roll card. Shuffle the city deck and draw one city card. Place the plane on the matching space on the board. In this case, Atlanta. Then you can discard the Atlanta city card. Next, draw two city cards and place them face up along the flight path next to the matching cities. Take the next three city cards and place them in HQ to create the city deck. Then you can take the remaining cards and put them in the box. Around the edge of the board, the city cards you placed earlier represent the locations of the disasters that are occurring. Each card shows the supplies that city needs, indicated by the different colors and icons on that card. In order to win the game, you'll have to travel to these locations and deliver the supplies they need. To do this, each player has their own set of dice that they'll use to move throughout the plane and activate the abilities of the different rooms. Players take their turns one at a time, but must do so as quickly as possible. Take too long and the timer will run out and you will lose the game. During a turn, each player will roll their dice and use the results to take various actions. A player may re-roll a dice they haven't used yet up to two times. To move around the plane, a player may spend a die showing any result to move their pawn from one room to an adjacent room. To fly the plane, a player may use a die result showing a plane icon to move the plane to an adjacent city in either direction. Now that this die has been used, place it on your roll card to indicate that you cannot roll it again. In order to prepare the supplies that each city will need, players must place the dice matching the supply room their pawn is in. As you can see, both cities need food. I will spend a die result to move myself into the food room. Then I will spend a food result to place it on the food track, beginning food production. Each group must be completed in the order shown by the direction of the arrows. The more dice you assign to a room, the more supplies that room will generate. But be careful, because the dice you place in a room will not return to you until after that room has been activated. There are three different types of rooms: supply rooms, the recycling center, and the cargo bay. To activate a room, you must be in that room. When a player activates a supply room, they take the number of crates shown by the farthest filled group of dice, in this case, one. Take the crate and move it to the cargo bay. Unfortunately, creating supplies can also generate waste. After activating one of the supply rooms, the players must roll all of the dice from that room. For each die result that shows a circular icon, the players must advance the waste track one. If the marker reaches the final space of the waste track, you and your team will lose the game. After activating the room, return the dice to the player's cards. Because supplies generate waste, you will need to reduce the waste track by activating the recycling center. To reduce waste, each player may assign non-matching dice to the recycling track. When you activate the recycling center, you may retreat the waste marker the number of spaces indicated by the furthest filled space on the recycling track. In this case, we will retreat the marker two spaces. Once you are done activating the recycling room, return the dice to the player cards. In order to deliver supplies to the cities in need, you must activate the cargo bay. To activate the cargo bay, three conditions must be met. First, one plane die must be assigned to the space in the cargo bay. Second, the plane must be in a space that contains a city card. And third, you must have one supply crate for each icon on the city card. In pandemic rapid response, you're racing against time. When the sand timer runs out, the players pause the current turn and discard one time token from HQ. Then flip the top card of the city deck, in this case Delhi, and place it next to the corresponding space on the board. Flip the timer and resume gameplay. If there are no time tokens remaining when the timer runs out, the players will immediately lose the game. If players have delivered supplies to all of the city cards, they win the game and save humanity. After you have some experience with the game, you may adjust the difficulty by increasing the number of city cards needed to build the city deck. Then you may introduce crisis cards for greater variety and new obstacles to overcome. For more information about Pandemic Rapid Response or the full game rules, visit zmangames.com.